Welcome to this new video of Roster Photo. Today we're going to talk about again Luminar 3, a new tip. Hopefully you learned something new, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel because soon we will publish more videos about Luminar 3. How to make a photo look sharper. That's what this video is about. As you can see in this photo, the foreground is sharp, the background is blurry. That's how I want it. But it will be nice if I can make the foreground even more sharper. And in Luminar 3, there are different ways to do that. And I want to show you my favorite options. I open here the detail enhancer, microstructure and sharpening. And there's also another filter structure. So also that makes a photo look more sharper, but to me, it influences too much of the rest of the photo. What I like about the detail enhancer is you can influence it by the size of the details, of by the subjects. So you have the small, medium and the large sliders. So you have more control over what to sharpen and what not. As you can see here in the foreground, there are a lot of small details in this part, so mainly by using this slider will influence the details here in the foreground. Microstructure, I can show you what it does. It also increases the structure in the foreground, but also in the background. And as you can see in the detail enhancer and in the sharpening filter, there is a masking you can apply, and that really helps to make sure, for this photo at least, to apply the details and the sharpening in the foreground and not in the background. And you cannot do that here in the microstructure. The only thing you can do is to apply a mask yourself, and then I think with the brush it's easily to brush the foreground out and only apply it for that part. But it takes more work and more time. So microstructure, I'm not gonna use it. I will show you why the detail enhancer and the sharpenings are my favorite. I will zoom in a little bit more so we can see the changes a little bit better. So as said before, there are a lot of details here in this part, so I want to increase this, and I will show you the before and the after, so that already makes a big difference. I also want to increase the medium to see what it does to this photo. I also think that improves the amount of details, maybe a bit too much. And usually what happens with detail enhancers is in other software you get a lot of noise also, but if I look at this filter, it looks pretty clean. So more details are visible and not too much noise at all. So I'm happy with the result. So what happens now is the details in the small and the medium details probably look better now, but it applies to the whole photo. Now there are not so many small medium details in the background, but still it's always good to use a mask, because now only the foreground will be influenced. And the only thing I don't like too much about Luminar is you cannot press a key in a keyboard to see where this filter is applied now. So it's kind of a guess. I put masking in 50% and I hope it doesn't influence the background too much. Of course we can check that by zooming in the background. I go to 100%. Let's wait until the image is processed, and let's turn off the filter and turn on. Well, there's a slight difference, but it's not much at all, so I'm quite happy with the result. So what can I do more? The sharpening, of course. There's also here in the add filters, in the issue fixers, you can find the sharpening filter. I already opened it here. Also here you can apply some extra sharpening. So in general, I use sharpening for every photo, and the amount of sharpening is hard to say because it really depends on what you're going to do with a photo. If you want to print a photo in a very large size, that photo needs more sharpening than when you're going to use it in only online, for example. So if you want to upload a photo to your Instagram or to your Facebook account, yeah, it doesn't need too much sharpening because the photo will be shown quite small. But for large prints, you really need more sharpening. So what I do here, I apply sharpening the amount that it looks nice in the screen, and if I really gonna use the photo for a large print, I review the photo and the sharpening again to see if I have to apply more. So sharpening is not one value for one photo, it really depends on where you're going to use the photo for. So also with the sharpening, you have the masking, it's very nice also. So it only applies to, not applies to every single pixel, but only to basically the lines. Also for this slider, there's no key in the keyboard, so you can check how much of where sharpening is applied in a photo. Hopefully it will be a feature added to the upcoming update of Luminar 3. So also for this we can turn it off and on, but from this view you won't see a difference, so you really have to zoom in to see the result. So let's do it again, before, after. So it makes a difference. So also for the background, I will check again if the amount of 42 is not too much. So also in the background, I zoom in to at least 100% and I turn it off, turn it on. I don't see any difference, so I think the masking of 35 is a good value to make sure it only applies here in the foreground. So this is what I wanted to show you, making a photo look sharper. It doesn't only happen with the sharpening filter, you can also use for example the details enhancer, because it really makes the photo a little bit better. So try to use those two filters, those are my favorite to make a photo look sharper. Hopefully you learned something new. Please leave a comment below this video. I love to hear what you think about this video.